Hello everybody, I'm Abraham Sandeep Samuel from MedCity Kottayam Color Trade Branch. And I'm an IELTS trainer. And here we're going to discuss on the writing topic on should euthanasia be made legal? So in the discussion we have Arun, another teacher here. And we have Hans, who is a senior teacher out here. Hi Arun, what do you think about euthanasia?
Well, euthanasia, there are two sides to it, and you can take it in one way, you can say that it can be made legal, and on the other hand, we can say that it shouldn't be made legal. There are two sides to it.
Well, we will start with today with discussing about the Belgian Paralympian, which is Marie Kay.
Marie Kay Verwoerd.
Yes, Marie Kay Verwoerd. It is a recent one we discussed, would like to talk about is how she wanted to do a voluntary death for herself because of a syndrome which cannot be
well,
cured.
Yeah, she was terminally ill and she had applied for getting euthanized almost 2 years back.
Yes.
And recently only the court there approved that. So that was a recent incident that happened. So in her country, that is Belgium, euthanasia is kind of legal. So that's why she was able to do that. So the question that we have here today is whether euthanasia should be made legal or shouldn't be made legal. So what do you think?
I think it should be made legal because there are many sicknesses in this world which cannot be cured. And many of the patients are suffering or are dying in pain. It might as well to end the misery. I think they should be given a chance to kill or die themselves voluntarily if they are okay with it, like, you know.
Well, I don't share your point of view. What I think is that if you can't give life, see, your life is a gift to you. You yourself didn't give life to you. So, like, I feel that at some point you are not supposed to take your own life, and I'm not being religious here, but it's my point of view.
What I feel in my point of view, what I like to stress is to end pain instead of suffering on the bed when no one's look after you, no medicines can cure you. It is might as well, like, you know, just give up and just go move on then. You know?
What I feel is that for every ailment or every affliction that we have on this earth, we have a solution. Only thing is that the pharmaceutical companies, I'm just going off topic a little bit because there are these pharmaceutical companies, huge pharma companies, and they don't want the suffering to end. We never had so many diseases back in maybe 20 or 30 years back. We never had so many diseases. It's our system or the world is actually fueling afflictions or fueling all these sufferings and all these diseases. Like, for example, let me say about cancer. We never had so many incidents of cancer back, maybe 20, 30 years back, nobody had even heard of cancer, but now we have so many cancer patients, and that too, I might sound a bit out of this world, but the scientist who discovered cancer cells for the first time, he told that cancer cells cannot survive in alkaline environment. But whereas the pharma companies are hiding these facts because they want it's profit for them. People suffering, it's profit for them. So, like, I feel that at some point for every disease, every serious disease, we have a cure. What do you have to say about that?
I think everybody has got a right. As nowadays in this new generations, what we are, everybody's got a right. Check out the lesbian and gays and transsexuals. They fought for their rights. And a lot of things has been changed recently. So I believe for people who want to die voluntarily, should be given a chance to die also.
It's another perspective. Of course, I agree with you that everybody has their own right to live or right to die. So, see, if you give right to live, I mean right to take life for everybody, it will certainly be misused. And for example, there could be cases like maybe some family member might himself take life of another, and they may frame others in the case, and then for wealth or for anything, it could be misused. And there can be very difficult situations, and whenever people feel they may take their own life. So I don't really agree with your point of view.
Yeah, I was listening to discussion on the topic whether euthanasia should be made legal or not. And I did infer from that that the discussion was good. Initially, what people do normally is that they start off with the definition of euthanasia. They go into the details of euthanasia. That didn't happen here. I'm glad. That kept the whole discussion going to the topic. So that is what we should do when you write. Don't go into the every detail of it. Don't go to the last T about topic. Go to the topic. Don't talk around the topic. But at the point where Arun talked about pharmaceutical companies, he went into cancer. He went into pharmaceutical companies trying to make profits. Well, the point was there. But then the explanation came down too much into the disease part, not into the topic of why it would be good if euthanasia were not made legal for the pharmaceutical companies. So that was a bit too lengthy. And the third part where Hans talked about this thing, what do you call, what is it, Hans? Everybody has a right to die. Well,
yeah.
That, I'm glad Hans put it by the end, because that's a weak point. So from here, we should gather one thing. See, a strong point should always be put first. And as you progress in an essay or maybe in a discussion, whatever, the weaker points come by the end. So that was nice, and that was a nice discussion. And we meet you, or we may come on camera for the next discussion. So till then, bye, and thank you from all of us.